Fed up with my lackluster garden blower, I embarked on a journey to build the ultimate jet-powered leaf blower that not only deletes leaves, but also everything else in its path. One of life's never-ending jobs is tidying up the backyard. From mowing the lawn to trimming the edges, it all makes a mess that then requires even more work to clean up. You can do this the old-fashioned way, or use technology to make your life a little easier. I choose to use a leaf blower, which works just okay for some of the time. I think we can do better than this. I've often wondered just what is inside my leaf blower. A cheap brush motor with a centrifugal fan, a micro switch, and, well, that's all. This little anemometer measures wind speed. My low-tier blower produces a velocity of 160 kilometers an hour and moves a volume of about 85 cubic feet per minute, which lines up with the manufacturer claims. But what about thrust? I strapped it onto a skateboard and used the GPS unit to measure its speed. Unsurprisingly, it barely managed a walking pace. I know that there are better blowers available, so I headed to my local hardware store to check out the range. All of the pricier models used axial fans rather than a centrifugal fan like mine. That gave me some ideas to think about while I got the broom out, since my blower was still in pieces. I headed to my local RC flying field to research propulsion methods. These planes use jet units capable of propelling them along at air speeds of over 300 kilometers an hour. I'd be happy if I could get anywhere near that speed. Inspired, I picked up an electric ducted fan unit, which would be the new power plant for my blower design. Now, I've worked a little with fan units before, but this is one high-performance unit approaching 5 kilograms of thrust. I charged some lipos and set up a bench test to make sure that the EDF setup works as it should. I used a servo tester, 110 amp electronic speed control, and two 5-cell lipo batteries in series to provide 10-cell power. That's about 40 volts. Moving on to the chassis design, and I used an RC car carbon plate style chassis as my inspiration to come up with something that didn't look like your average blower. It has more of a hobbyist look that I kind of like. The design uses the aluminium fan unit as a stressed member, so I used a high temperature nylon carbon fiber filled filament to provide the strength that I needed. The PPA parts are perfectly rigid for this application. Some parts were also printed from PLA and ABS filaments where strength was less important. There are about 25 3D printed parts all up. The main components of the chassis are an interference fit for the fan unit and are secured to its small aluminium brackets using 3mm stainless steel hardware. This forms the bulk of the chassis and provides space for the rest of the blower parts to attach to. This is a part that mounts below the fan unit and will house the LiPo batteries. The side plates hold the electronics. I don't have a router to cut out carbon plate, so I had to cheat here a little. I found some very thin carbon twill sheet that I was able to cut using a stencil, knife, and scissors. The various bracketry that houses the electrical components was attached to the side plates of the blower. The base of the cantilever handle attaches to the chassis using a fastener. I used 25mm carbon fiber tube that I had laying around as the handle. The wiring for the throttle runs through the handle and is controlled with a knob attached to a potentiometer. I had some leftover electronics from a lighting project that I decided to use to add some life to the blower. The LED strip is wired to a microcontroller that powers up with the fan. I installed the LEDs in the fan inlet underneath the lip. The inlet lip is printed from PLA and provides some diffusion for the light. WLED is installed on the microcontroller so that I can control the lights wirelessly from my phone or PC. After wiring the remaining electronic components, I was happy to see that everything was working. I picked up some 90mm roll wrapped carbon fiber tube to serve as the blower's draft tube. It attaches to the blower chassis using extension springs to keep everything nice and snug. This was inspired by the springs that secure some motorcycle exhausts. I printed an end tube that reduces the draft tube diameter by about 20% to maximise velocity. And with that, it was time to test what the blower can do. I had to add some more weight to my measuring setup here. I think I ended up maxing out the anemometer at 233 km/h, which equates to an air volume of about 557 cubic feet per minute. I gave it a real-world test in the backyard and it was impressive. But the blower was heavy and when combined with the thrust was hard to hold. I added a side handle to make it easier to control. I also added some finishing touches. And given the blower's similarity in wind speed to the cyclones we experience here in parts of Australia, I named it the Synclone, Synclone or something. I temporarily added some RC throttle control to test out the thrust performance of the blower. I could probably have used some more open space, but it was definitely an improvement over the performance of the shop-bought blower. There aren't a lot of leaves that need tidying where I live, so I headed to the nearby town of Bright, home to the Ovens River and beautiful wildlife, but perhaps most famously known for its autumn colour when the leaves on the trees light up the town. In fact, Bright has so many leaves during the autumn months that it causes some of the town's visitors to behave strangely, and keeps the locals flat out. But I've come along with the latest in leaf moving technology to help them out on my first blowjob. And after a hard day's work moving leaves around, it was time for me to relax.